Her Excellency, this is Manchushi, my lord, the designated minister of the people of Seychelles. Mr. Jamsir Adiwala, chairman of the Indian Association of Seychelles. Mr. Kannan Pillai from Hindu Council of Seychelles. Office bearers and organizing members of today's cultural event. Distinguished guests, respected elders, dear brothers and sisters, and my dear children. Good evening to all of you. And I am aware that the mesmerizing cultural program, we have just seen the glimpses presented by our very dear, very small children, is awaiting us. I'll not take more than maybe 4 to 5 minutes. And at the outset, I must compliment just the trailer that we saw, our children. It's actually mesmerizing, super, and very, very patriotic. It gives me immense pleasure to be amongst you all once again today, after we met during the flag hoisting ceremony by me, which was the first one by me in Seychelles on the eve of 73rd Independence Day of India on 15th August. In fact, my gratitude and my compliments to the Indian diaspora, Indian community, and Seychelles, who came in great number this year for the flag hoisting ceremony. My compliments to the ladies who sang patriotic songs that day, and also compliments to most of them were same children, small, very small, and the young girls who performed on patriotic songs. They were truly amazing, and the way we see today. Indian citizens have a special people-to-people link and strong cultural bonding which spans over 2 centuries. It was in the year 1770 that a small group of 5 Indians, 7 African slaves and 15 French colonizers that landed in Seychelles, on the Seychelles Islands. And Indians came basically as the plantation workers. And they came looking for greener pastures, since the East Africa had reached the saturation point. And those were the ones who are the first settlers on the islands of Seychelles. During British colonial period, Seychelles was governed from the Bombay Presidency for some time, with regular shipping links and flow of goods and essential commodities from India. These trade links facilitated migration of these Indian trading companies that I mentioned. India's bilateral engagement with Seychelles has evolved in the last few decades. And today, India-Seychelles relations are characterized by close friendship, understanding, and cooperation. It is this strong cultural link that has kept the relationship growing. There are close to 10,000 Indian citizens holding gainful occupation permit, GOP, who are mostly in the construction sector, hospitality, and various other professions here. The Indian diaspora is visibly in all walks of life and is well known for their professionalism and hard work. Apart from working tirelessly for the economic growth of Seychelles, the Indian diaspora has also been quite active in public life. The prestigious Pravasi Bharatiya Samman Award conferred on Dr. V. Ram Dass in 2006 and on Justice D. Karunakaran in 2015 are notable examples of that. In the recent past, our young members from the diaspora have brought in more laurels to Seychelles with Mr. Deepak and Mr. Mathur representing Seychelles in Mandela Gandhi Young Leaders Conference in South Africa and Mrs. Khushbu Dubey representing Seychelles in reaching to the last stage of Bharat Ko Janiye quiz held in New Delhi last year. I am very sure that our diaspora population will work for the betterment of Seychelles' economy as also for India-Seychelles relationship. I take this opportunity to compliment both the Indian Association of Seychelles and Indian Hindu Culture of Seychelles. Hindu Council of Seychelles for organizing this jointly for the first time, the cultural program on the eve of 73rd Independence Day of India. I would also like to wish both the organizations all the very best in their endeavors. I would also take this opportunity to wish the Indian community, the Indian diaspora, the Seychelles, all the very best in their future endeavors. Thank you. Dhanyavaad. Jai Hind.